हेलो दोस्तों, मैं सागर बम्बोली आप सभी का फिर से एक बार स्वागत करता हूँ मेरे यूट्यूब चैनल में, जिसका नाम है कॉमर्स ट्रेजर। सो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अनदर टॉपिक ऑन हायर एजुकेशन सिस्टम। द टॉपिक विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे इज़ हायर लर्निंग एंड एंशंट एजुकेशन इंस्टीट्यूशंस इन इंडिया। सो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक विच वॉज आस्क लास्ट टाइम इन ऑल द सेट्स ऑफ एग्जाम्स ऑफ पेपर वन एज वेल एज इन कॉमर्स पेपर ऑल्सो दिस वॉज आस्क लास्ट टाइम। सो दिस टाइम ऑल्सो इट इज़ गोइंग टू बी अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फॉर द अपकमिंग एग्जाम। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग मच टाइम, लेट स्टार्ट द डिस्कशन। वॉच द वीडियो टिल एंड बिकॉज इट इज़ गोइंग टू बी अ लॉन्गर वीडियो बट अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वीडियो। एजुकेशन इन इंडिया वॉज मेनली टॉट अंडर टू सिस्टम्स। वन वॉज बुद्धिस्ट सिस्टम वेर देर वर थ्री मेजर सब्जेक्ट्स एंड सेकेंड वन वॉज वैदिक सिस्टम वेर इन दे यूज टू टीच फोर वेदास, दैट इज ऋग्वेदा, समावेदा, यजुर्वेदा एंड अथर्ववेदा, एंड दे यूज टू टीच वेदांगास, पुराणास, देन तर्कशास्त्र, उपनिषद्स। ईच वेदा यूज टू टेक अराउंड 12 ईयर्स टू गेट मास्टरी। सो टू स्टडी फोर वेदास दे यूज टू स्टडी फॉर अबाउट 48 ईयर्स। सो फ्रेंड्स, आई हैव मार्क्ड ऑल द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स विच यू हैव टू रिमेंबर फ्रॉम एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू इन रेड। You can just see it on your screen. So just go on studying those points I am going to discuss with you in next 10 to 15 minutes. The first institution is Pushpagiri. Pushpagiri was established in 3rd century AD and it was where now present Odisha is, and it was continued up to 11th century, for 800 years it was in existence. Now what you have to remember about Pushpagiri, it was an ancient Buddhist Mahavihara. And one more very important point which was asked last time in commerce exam first paper was a Chinese traveler who traveled in India to write about all the main ancient institution was Xuanzang, or he is also called as Xuanzang, right? You can just see it on the screen. So he was a person who came to India in 639 AD from China, and he has written about all the major institutions in India for higher education. Now one more important point what you can remember about Pushpagiri was it was spread across three adjoining hills. Those hills were Lalitgiri, Ratnagiri and Udayagiri, right? In Pushpagiri they used to teach many subjects and many students were attracted around the globe and they used to study in Pushpagiri University. The second university which you have to remember and which is a very very important university from exam point of view is Nalanda University. Now Nalanda University, you have to remember that it was established in the year 427 AD, right friends, 427 AD, and it was there up to 1197 AD. So it was located in the ancient kingdom of Magad. You have to remember this point, which is presently 7 miles from Rajgriha, which is now in Bihar. And it is one of the greatest universities of the world. At that time, it was an international university where people from different countries used to come and study. If we compare it presently, it is something like Oxford or Cambridge or Harvard University, what we have today. So who established this university? It is said that Kumara Gupta I from Gupta dynasty was the one who founded the University of Nalanda. And there, students were trained in Buddhist study, fine arts, medicine, mathematics, astronomy, politics and art of war. So remember all these things, these were the subjects which were taught in that university. Now why this is famous? See, this is a university which is very famous at that time for Buddhist monks or Buddhist study, and one of the favorite disciple of Gautam Buddha, that is Sariputta. Right friends, he was the favorite disciple of Gautam Buddha. He was born in that particular place, and that's why it became a very important place for Buddhist studies. Now next, what you can remember friends is it was a university which had 8 separate compounds. You can just understand what would be the size of the university. It had 10 temples, it had meditation halls, classrooms, lakes, parks, etc. A very important point which you have to remember is that it had 9-story library, 9 floors library, and there were big dormitories. Dormitories is nothing but like hostels or big halls where students can live. It had around 10,000 students and around accommodation for 2,000 teachers or professors. So as I said friends, people from different country used to come in that era. People from Sri Lanka, Korea, Japan, China, Tibet, Indonesia, Persia, etc., which you can see on your screen, used to come there for studies. Now at that time, friends, this university conducted entrance exams and only 20% of the students could pass the entrance exam. So this was the level of university admission in that particular era, which was written by Yuan Shang, who was a Chinese traveler. The next point what you have to remember, friends, is the age criteria. A person who attains the age of 20 could get admission in this particular university. So if you are less than 20 years, you do not get admission. Only if you are 20 and plus, you would get admission in this university. So education was free of cost, and mainly there were three methods of teaching which they used to use. One was verbal and explanatory teaching, which you can remember. Second one was giving lectures, and third was debate and discussions. So around 100 lectures were delivered on daily basis, and each student has to compulsory attend all the lectures. Now again, a very important point, friends, which you have to remember is this university was destroyed by Bakhtiar Khilji, a Turkish Muslim ruler, in 1193 AD. So Bakhtiar Khilji destroyed three universities in India. I'll tell you all the three universities as we go further in the video. But what he did was, he set the libraries to fire and he killed many acharyas or gurus and students of that university. Now one more very important point which you have to remember is, in 2010, modern Nalanda University was established as a central university in our country near Rajgir in Bihar. So it is now India's standalone international university. So remember, friends, in order to restore the same university at the same place, now they had made a new Nalanda University, which is a very important question. So this was about Nalanda University. Now we'll study about one more very, very important university of ancient India, which is Takshila or Takshashila University. Now what all you have to remember about Takshashila University? See, Takshashila University was located in Gandhar, which was an early center for Hindu as well as Buddhist system of learning. So it is believed by some people that the Kuru prince Duryodhana, now everybody knows about Duryodhana, he was the person who fought against Pandavas or the five Pandavas in the Mahabharata Yudh, and he is said to laid the foundation of Takshashila University at his mother's birthplace. So presently, if we say, it would have been somewhere near Rawalpindi district in Pakistan, and the school consisted of several monasteries. But there was no big large lecture halls or dormitories, and there mainly what you have to remember is they used to get teaching on individualistic basis. So one-to-one teaching was given at that time in Takshila or Takshashila University. Now about this university, detail has been written in Jataka Tales. You have to remember this, friends, Jataka Tales, which is written in Sri Lanka around 5th century. So they wrote about Takshashila or Takshila University. And this university is said to be one of the world's oldest university. So you have to remember, friends, which is the world's oldest university? It is Takshashila University. Now what all you have to remember, it was a university for only higher education, right, friends? Only a person who crosses the age of 16 could enter into this university. So what all they taught there, they taught various subjects, and student had a choice to select any subject of his interest. So they used to teach Vedas, Vedantas, Vyakarana, that is grammar, Ayurveda, that is medical, surgery, and 18 crafts which were called as Sipas, and also about military education, about warfare or archery, astronomy, agriculture, commerce, politics, and about snake bite cure, etc. So these were some important subjects which were taught in Takshila University. So in that time, around 10,500 students came across different Aryavart or different areas, and also people from Greece, Arabia, and China came to this university, and they used to study in this particular university. So all these points you have to keep in your minds. Now coming to the most important point which you have to remember about this university is, this university has given some of the greatest known persons in our ancient history. So Chanakya, all of us know about Chanakya, he was the one who wrote the book Arthashastra. It is said that he wrote that book in Takshashila itself. Not only Chanakya, the Mauryan Empire Chandragupta Maurya also studied there. The Ayurvedic healer or the medical expert Charaka was also a part of this university. The Sanskrit linguistic and grammarian Panini is also a very famous person. He was also the part of this university. And Vishnu Sharma, a famous author, is also part of this तक्षशिला यूनिवर्सिटी. सो ऑल ऑफ दीज पीपल स्टडीड इन तक्षशिला यूनिवर्सिटी. सो होप इट इज क्लियर टू यू फ्रेंड्स. नालंदा एंड तक्षशिला यूनिवर्सिटी आर टू वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड्स विच यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट टू इन डिटेल. द नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट यूनिवर्सिटी इज विक्रमशिला यूनिवर्सिटी. नाउ फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज ऑल्सो अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट यूनिवर्सिटी एंड it was an important university along with the Nalanda University. This two university was somewhere near Bihar in the northern Magad region at that time, and this is said to be established by the Pala king Dharmapala. Remember this friends, Dharmapala was one who established this university in the year 783 AD, and it was there up to 820 AD. Friends, what all again you have to remember about Vikramshila? Vikramshila was one of the largest Buddhist universities which was there in the world, and it had around 100 teachers and 1000 students who used to study in that particular time. So not only that, it was the university which was spreading Buddhist learning, culture and religion in that era. What all subjects were taught in that university? Philosophy, grammar, metaphysics, Indian logic, etc. were some of the important subjects, but the main and the most important subject was Tantrism. Buddhist Tantrism was the main subject which you have to remember. This university had 6 huge colleges, and there was one big building at the center. The name of the building was Vigyan Bhavan. So just remember friends, 6 colleges in that particular university and one major central building which was called as Vigyan Bhavan. And it had 6 gates which connected the university, and there was a Dwar Pandit who was appointed as a main guard or the main keeper. So again friends, this was destroyed by Muhammad bin Bakhtiar Khilji. As I said you friends, he destroyed 3 university in which Vikramshila was also one. The next university which you have to remember is Mithila University. Now what all you can remember, it was a university where main subject was Brahmanical system. So they used to teach Brahmanical system of education, and it was also called as Videha. You can remember this name friends. Videha was another name of Mithila University. Now this university became more popular during the Raja Janak period, where he used to conduct many religious conferences where Rishi used to come and take part. Now Raja Janak is one, you can remember in Ramayana, he was a father of Sita. So at that time it was a very popular university. Now what all were the subjects taught in that university? Literature and fine arts were main. Science related subject were taught, and also scriptures including about Vedas and Nyaya Shastra, which is law, were the main subjects in that particular university. And lastly, what you can remember about this university is in that university proper exams were conducted every year, and only if you pass in the exam they used to give the degree or they used to give the educational certificate in that particular time. Now next university is also an university which you can remember only main points, which is Telhara University. Now Telhara University also is somewhere near your Nalanda University. It was in a distance around 40 kilometers from Nalanda University. So again this Chinese traveler Yuan Sang and one more traveler It Singh also have mentioned about this in their study when they came to India about higher research on ancient institutions, and it was said as a competitor to Nalanda University in that particular time. It had a 3-story building structure and a prayer hall and a platform where 1000 monks used to sit and study about Mahanaya Buddhism. The main important topic which was studied in that center was Tantric Buddhism, which I told you earlier also. So one more important point which you can remember. So again the same person Bakhtiar Khilji in the year 1193 destroyed this university also. So the 3 university which he destroyed were, one was Nalanda University, second one was Vikramshila University, and third one was Telhara University. So all 3 universities were destroyed by Khilji. The next university which is again a bit important which you can remember is Vallabhi University. Now Vallabhi University was set up along with Nalanda University at the same time by the Maitraka dynasty. Now this is also as old as Nalanda University. So it was somewhere around now where present Gujarat or Saurashtra is. It was in that particular place in the western India, and it was one of the glorious university in western India or the main university. In the 8th century Arab, when Arab came to India, they destroyed some of the portion of this university, but still this university after some repairs continued up to 12th century. So these all points which you can remember about Vallabhi University. सो वॉट आर द मेजर सब्जेक्ट्स टॉट इन दैट यूनिवर्सिटी? इकोनॉमिक्स वॉज वन ऑफ द मेन सब्जेक्ट, लॉ वॉज मेन, पॉलिटिक्स, मेडिकल, बुक कीपिंग. सी फ्रेंड्स, दिस वॉज नॉट टॉट इन अदर यूनिवर्सिटीज. सो बुक कीपिंग, लिटरेचर, व्याकरण दैट इज ग्रामर, एंड वन इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग विच यू हैव टू रिमेंबर इज हीनायना बुद्धिज्म. राइट फ्रेंड्स, तांत्रिक बुद्धिज्म यू हैव स्टडीड. नाउ दिस इज वन मोर पॉइंट विच यू कैन रिमेंबर. हीनायना बुद्धिज्म वॉज टॉट इन वल्लभी यूनिवर्सिटी. राइट फ्रेंड्स, सो अगेन अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस वॉट यू कैन रिमेंबर, इट वॉज अ यूनिवर्सिटी वेर लॉट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स वर अट्रैक्टेड एंड पीपल फ्रॉम डिफरेंट एरियाज यूज टू कम देयर टू गेट डिग्री फ्रॉम दिस यूनिवर्सिटी. एंड नॉट ओनली दिस, चाइनीज ट्रैवलर इत्सिंग हैज रिटन अबाउट दिस यूनिवर्सिटी, हु स्टडीड एट नालंदा यूनिवर्सिटी एंड विजिटेड इट यूनिवर्सिटी इन द 7th century. द नेक्स्ट थ्री आर यूनिवर्सिटी अबाउट विच यू हैव टू नॉट रिमेंबर वेरी मच, जस्ट रिमेंबर द नेम्स एंड हु गेव दिस यूनिवर्सिटी एंड द मेन सब्जेक्ट्स. सो नेक्स्ट वन इज ओदांतापुरी यूनिवर्सिटी. नाउ वेन इट वॉज सेटअप इन ओदांतापुरी विच इज समवेयर नियर बिहार एंड दैट इज इन द मगध रीजन एट दैट टाइम. इट वॉज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज उदानापुरा. राइट फ्रेंड्स, उदानापुरा यू कैन रिमेंबर, एंड इट वॉज सेटअप बाय द पाला किंग गोपाला इन द अर्ली 7th century. सो रिमेंबर दिस थ्री पॉइंट्स. इट वॉज देयर इन मगध, एस्टाब्लिश बाय किंग गोपाला, and it was also called as Udanapura. Now again, this university attracted a lot of students from different places, but it could not attain fame like Nalanda or Vikramshila University. So here major of the students were Tibetan students who used to come here for their studies, and it is said that around 12,000 students were there in this university at some points, and subjects were regarding to Vedic scriptures and Buddhism related subjects which you can remember. The next one is Somapur University. Friends, Somapur University again was established by King Dharmapala, one more university established which we saw previously. So it was established in the 7th century, and again this university was as big as your Nalanda University, where different subjects were taught, and mainly your three religions related subjects were taught, that is Hinduism, Buddhism and Jainism. You can remember these three religion about which it was taught in Somapura University. And again, what you can remember, so same, because of some Muslim leaders, when they entered, they destroyed this university. Up to that, it was again a very important university from our ancient university point of view. The last university which I am going to discuss today is Nadia University. Now, Nadia University was also called as Navadvipa University. You can remember this, Navadvipa University. It was located on bank of river Ganga and Jalangni rivers in Bengal, and it was set up after the destruction of Nalanda and Takshashila University. So once those university were destroyed, this was set up. Now here subject relating to logic, Vyakarana were taught, and not only that, politics and law was also taught in this particular university. So they had three main centers. One was Navadvipa, second one was Shantipur, and third was Gopalapura. So you can remember these three names which were the main university sites. So this was all about higher learning and ancient education institutions in India, friends. So just remember all the points which I highlighted in red color, because those are the one which can be asked in your exams for your paper 1 higher education system. If you like the video, friends, please hit the like button, and if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, please subscribe my channel and please press the bell icon so that you can get the notification as soon as I come up with the new video. So thank you, friends, for watching the video. If you want me to make a video on any specific topic, please comment me in the comment box so I can make those videos for you.